Good morning, beloved of God. It's another terrific Tuesday here at the God Minute. This is Father Michael, along with the rest of our team, welcoming you to our time together in prayer today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 9. Lift my spirits that I may be of use. I give thanks with my whole heart for every rock of the earth, every star of the sky. I will rejoice in you and be glad, and sing psalms to your name, O Most High.
I praise you for your presence in my heart, O God, which makes me strong and unafraid. You are a refuge for the oppressed and troubled. Those who put their trust in you are comforted.
Whisper in my heart, O God, for I am tormented by difficulties and discouraged by the awful state of the world.
Lift my spirits so that I may be of use, and trap the wicked with the works of their own hands. Help me to set things right so that the needy are not forgotten and the poor have hope.
For we were created in your image, and our life should be a blessing to us all.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18, verses 1 to 5. The disciples approached Jesus and said, "Who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven?" He called a child over, placed it in their midst, and said, "Amen, I say to you, unless you turn and become like children, you will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Whoever becomes humble like this child is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The other day at ministry, I was over at the coffee machine, and one of the teachers came over with one of her little helpers, meaning a kiddo who needed to take a little break from the classroom and focus on another task. And whenever I see a little helper with their teacher, I always try to provide some positive praise for their behavior, like, "Oh, I love how you're helping Miss Brittany," or, "I love how you're staying close to your grown-up while walking in the hallway," or, "I love how you're using those walking feet." You get the picture, right? Well, as I approached the copier, our little helper was so excited to see me and started jumping up and down. "Sister Kara," he said. "Sister Kara, look. Look at my elbows." He then demonstrated the most dramatic imitation of a bodybuilder bicep flex I've ever seen from a four-year-old. "Oh, wow," I commented. "I see your muscle. Look at that big muscle." As I pointed to his bicep, he was eager to show me. I also pointed to his elbow and said, "And I see your elbow, too." And then while pointing, I commented, "I see your muscle and your elbow." Can't pass up an opportunity to clarify some vocabulary and build up his semantic knowledge, right? Kids can be hilarious. I know I share my experiences with the kiddos during reflection from time to time. In a ministry where I work pretty exclusively with young children ages birth to five, Jesus' words are often at the forefront of my prayer, especially as I engage in apostolic reflection, when Jesus says, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me." Although children can, you know, throw some pretty intense temper tantrums, especially in the line at the grocery store, right, parents? There are qualities of children that Jesus is drawing our attention to, qualities that we can learn from as we consider the kingdom of God. Little children are those innocent people who are ready to be taught. They might sit patiently beside you and attentively listen to what you have to say, especially if you're engaging in something that has really caught their attention, like bubbles or, you know, creating a rousing rendition of Baby Shark, you know. Jesus wants us to behave likewise towards him and his teachings. Little children also do not have preconceived opinions about things, unless they have dubbed a certain kind of food as icky. They don't display prejudice or bias towards a subject. They see something for what it is, as opposed to how, in their opinion, it should be like. Therefore, Jesus tells us to accept him, his teachings, and his kingdom as he teaches. And when you compare us grown-ups and little children, you'll notice that grown-ups' hearts, minds, bodies, souls, they can be marked by life's experiences, for better or for worse. Children are very innocent, and to them, love for others comes first, and is manifested well when you see them playing together, regardless of their race, tribe, religion, social status, you know. The humility of little children is always very overwhelming. They do not discriminate against anybody. Perhaps you can think of some other qualities of children that Jesus might be getting at as he encourages us to become like children, as we humble ourselves for the kingdom of heaven. So just like the little one proudly flexing his elbows for me, let us embrace the humble and simple qualities of children as we make our way this day. Pay attention to the little ones around you and take in the wonder and awe of life's moments.
Children of the world, and for the childlike innocence they possess, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. God of wonders, hear our prayer. Listen to our cry as we put our faith and trust in you. Give us only what we need so that we may accomplish your will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone, for joining us in prayer today. Thanks, Sister Kara, for your beautiful reflection that reminds us of that beautiful childlike innocence that we desire and that we are able to possess because of the grace of God. Take good care of yourselves and one another. And we'll see you tomorrow.